Hey, what's up guys? Welcome back. You're watching ProTech. Lots of famous custom ROMs are ready to release their Android system based builds. In upcoming days, they will release their final stable versions of their builds. But one team, that is Evolution X, already started to roll out their new initial Evolution X Android system based custom ROM for their official devices. But you got its unofficial ported custom JSA build by developer dozeoff. So you can enjoy the new Android 16 Evolution X on any device. Poco X2 also got an unofficial custom ROM version. Its link is available in video description. Today in this video, we'll review this new build. It's about device details, its working features for JSA build, all working Android 16 features, and at the end for JSA build, we mentioned some bugs and missing features. So if your device got the official Evolution X build, then you will get idea which Android 16 features are available and which are missing in this build. Other device users will get idea is it really worth to use Evolution X 11 JSA build or not. So watch this video till the end. Now without further delay, let's get started. We booted new Evolution X 11 JSA on our OnePlus 9RT. This device details section has these details. This is the Evolution X Stable Droid Android 16 JSA build with this new Android 16 Easter egg, which comprises of new mini spaceship Easter egg game. Security patches are of June 2025. Maintainer of this ROM is dozeoff, which is porting and regularly supporting almost all custom JSA ROMs. Build date of this build is 16 June 2025. This is based on the stable Android 16 release version BP28.25.06.05.031.83. Let's check out what's working in this build. Almost all essential features like Wi-Fi, Wi-Fi hotspot, Bluetooth, NFC, GPS, Chromecast all are working good. Always on display is also working, but if you face any problems, then you can manually enable it through PHS table setting. I did thorough testing of all important sensors like accelerometer, light, proximity, magnetometer, compass, gyroscope, and everything is working perfectly. Other important features like mic, ear speakers, display, multi-touch, and other important things during the test was successful and working. Incoming and outgoing calls with voice are also working. Most of banking and payment applications with messaging applications are working, but JSA build have some major bugs and missing features that we will discuss in the bug section of this video. Now we'll check out all the important Android 16 features which are working in this build. First is a new expressive design 3 user interface. It's available for QS panel. All the tiles and the brightness slider have this new look with new on and off switch animations. QS panel is a transparent by default and there is no customizations are available for now to change it. Who gets the new background blur effect while accessing the QS and notification panel. Expressive design made amazing changes for new settings panel. It has new rounded shape with colored icons for different settings options. Switches of different options have this new X and right tick mark like toggles user interface. Apps option also got this new rounded material hue color for different setting. So these are some user interface changes I found, except that most of Android system features are available in this ROM. Like in system and gestures, we got this option to access Google Wallet application by double pressing power button. On home screen, long press shortcut, who gets new app list option to access all app drawer applications. But old swipe up gesture on the home screen is efficient way to access the app drawer as compared to new app list feature. For recent panel, Android 16 added new close and select shortcuts for long press menu. New live notifications is a main feature of Android 16, which shows the live notifications of ongoing activities. Like this Android 16 spaceship Easter egg game auto mode movements. Even this will be useful to track order status of some food delivery applications like Zomato, Swiggy, etc. These are all minimal features of new user interface changes of new Android 16 Evolution X and its features. But these days build have some bugs, like Google Gemini is working but circle to search is not working at all, even if I enable long press navbar toggle in a navigation gesture setting. But you can use iCard video to enable this feature in any ROM. Wallpaper and style application is very laggy and force closes most of the time when you tries to apply wallpapers, so you have to apply wallpapers through photos application directly. No fingerprint and face unlocks are working, so you need to protect your device using password or pattern unlock only. Network and internet both are working, but in status bar, network and signal indicators are not visible. Calling is only working on 2G network, no VoLT and VoNR calls are available. Material U3 expressive design only available for QoS panel and some other settings. New wallpaper cinematic effects are not available in this build. As this is the early vanilla build of Evolution X, there are no any Evolver customizations are available. Play integrity checks got failed and Google Play Protect is uncertified. Still, most of banking and payment application with messaging applications are working. Remember, except missing user interface features, other bugs are not present in custom ROM because of dedicated device support of official maintainers of Evolution X team. Different devices which are using the GSM may or may not face these bugs, or they may face different bugs. This is all about for this new early Evolution X 11. As per my opinion, custom ROM users can definitely upgrade to this build, but GSM users first test this using DSU loader and then decide does it work to use this on your device or not. Hope you guys liked our work. Then please do like and share this video, subscribe to our channel, press the bell icon for notifications of our upcoming content. Thanks for watching. See you next time. Take care. Bye bye.